Developing flexible and stretchable circuits is a rewarding way to push the limits of electronics, their form factors, and their applications. But it often requires connecting those flexible and stretchable substrates to each other, or even to a traditional PCB or breadboard for testing. In this video, we're exploring what you can do after you finish a print in order to create a reliable connection between flexible, stretchable, and rigid substrates. The first connection we want to make is for a capacitive touch circuit. Capacitive touch uses the changes in conductivity caused by a human finger, for example, to detect touch. We've printed the capacitive touch circuit onto PET with a capped on tape backing to reduce interference. In order to test its functionality, we'll need to create a connection from the flexible PET to this traditional PCB on FR1. There are a couple different ways you could do this, but for our purposes, we'll be using a ZIF connection. Benefits of using a ZIF connector include its low profile, high pin count, and it's also not a permanent connection, which means it's not destructive. ZIF connectors are one of the most common connections used in production today, and it can be seen especially in electronics that prioritize miniaturization given its low profile. Our next print is a force-sensitive resistor, which detects a change in resistance when force is either increased or decreased on the surface of the circuit. This FSR was also printed on PET, but this time we'll use a crimp connector. The benefits of using a crimp connector include that they're easy to use, they interface well with other standard prototyping hardware like breadboards, they're durable and are reusable in that it creates a permanent connection but can be plugged in and out nearly as many times as you want. Next up, we have a flex sensor, which detects changes in resistance when the sensor is bent. This sensor was printed on PET, again, a flexible substrate. We'll also be using a crimp connector, but in this instance, we're using a flat flexible cable connector, or FFC, to make this crimp connection. These connectors don't require special tooling. They can be done by hand, are user-friendly, but again, are permanent and semi-destructive. We see crimp connectors of this style used in automotive applications, such as wiring harnesses, battery packs, and in crimped wire terminals. Our next connection will be done using snap connectors. For this, we have ECG electrodes printed on TPU and a heated mitten printed directly onto cotton fabric. If you're interested in seeing these full projects start to finish, check out the videos we have on each of them. The benefits of using snap connectors include that they can be extremely small, they're durable, and they can be connected and disconnected at will. Snap connectors are commonly used in connecting medical devices, smart garments, and e-textiles. Next, we've printed a custom ribbon cable on TPU, our first stretchable substrate connection. For this, we're going to use the insulation displacement connector, which is often used for cutting through wires, but in this case, we're using it to poke through the substrate to create an electrical contact. Benefits to IDC connections include that they're quick and easy to use, commonly available, and easy to connect and reinforce stretchable material. But on the other hand, this connection is another one that is permanent and semi-destructive. Our last print is a strain gauge on TPU. We're going to be connecting this stretchable substrate to a set of flexible wires on polyamide, which will then be connected to a rigid PCB using Z-axis tape. Z-axis tape is a double-sided tape that contains silver particles, allowing it to create electrical circuit connections. The tape is placed on the top of one connecting pad on the substrate, and the second circuit is placed on top of the tape. The silver particles in the Z-axis tape create connections up and down along the Z-axis between the substrates, but the particles are far enough apart that it does not create a connection side to side. Benefits of this method are that it's a quick and easy process and that the tape itself is flexible, unlike snaps or alligator clips. We see Z-axis tape connections used in LCD screens, touchscreens, display panels, and wearable sensors. These are a few of the common methods used to create connections between substrates. There are others that can be used that follow the same general principle and may be more appropriate for your project. But all of them can open doors for you to test and integrate your flexible and stretchable electronics into functional circuits after they've been printed.